Hello, my name is Russell Hercules. I am a product manager on the R&D team with Project Operations. Today we will review core project planning and resource management scenarios along with upcoming investments in the application. Project planning and estimation in Project Operations seamlessly integrates estimates of project delivery costs within the sales cycle, thus minimizing error, duplication of effort, while affording teams the ability to provide detailed resource-based estimates. In the upcoming demo, we will review three main components required to develop an estimate: defining a bookable resource, building a price list, and defining the work breakdown structure. Now I'm going to demonstrate how to create a bookable resource. Bookable resources comprise of multiple supported types: user, contact, equipment, account. For this example, we'll start with a contact. Once the resource has been defined, the next step is to associate and define the level of utilization and associated roles and skills that this resource will have in the application. Once the skills and roles have been defined, the next step is to define the working hours that the resource will be available for booking. Price lists and project operations represent a catalog of rates. The rates express cost, sales, and bill rates. Depending on whether the price list express cost rates or sales and bill rates, the context of the price list is sales or cost. From a project planning perspective, team members defined on the work breakdown structure express their effort across a time phase scale. That effort for each resource assignment is then multiplied by the associated cost and sales price list to develop the time phased estimates. So user will navigate to the price list, hit the section related to the role prices, and to add a new role price, you'll specify the role and provide a price. In the sales cycle, the sales team will develop an initial quote for a project and then hand it off to the delivery team for estimation. Leveraging Project Operations, that quote and its details can be integrated with one or many projects for estimation. In the preceding example, we will review how the work breakdown structure is developed along with the estimations at the project level. And then we will demonstrate how that estimation is then linked to the quote to fulfill the sales cycle. And in this demo, I'm going to demonstrate how we leverage the project planning capabilities and Project Operations to build a bottoms-up estimate for the quotes on your projects. In partnership with the Microsoft Office project team, Project Operations has integrated the new Project for the Web scheduling engine within the work breakdown structure of the Project Operations application. With this new scheduling capability, Project Operations brings rich scheduling functionality with the emphasis on user experience, but backed by a robust scheduling engine based upon 20 years of scheduling IP. In the grid view, project managers have the ability to personalize the project planning experience by specifying the columns and their associated order. With desktop-like controls, project managers have the ability to drag and drop, multi-select, cut and paste, and even leverage undo-redo to quickly build a work breakdown structure. Using the fixed duration schedule mode, users can define a task where they're able to hold duration constant regardless of the changes to the effort, thus allowing project managers to focus on planned delivery dates. Project Operations also supports scenarios when a task will start and end within the same day, as well as it provides support for milestones, otherwise known as zero duration tasks. When assigning resources, project operations affords project managers the ability to define named resources as well as placeholder resources when estimating the project. The named resources can be determined at the time the project has been created or booked later, as will be covered in later sections. In the board view, project operations supports customers who prefer a more agile methodology to scheduling projects. These views provide many of the editing capabilities in the grid view and give the project manager the flexibility to define local buckets tailored to the specific needs of their project scenario. A highly useful board view is the view where you can group by assign to. This gives project managers an informative visualization of the tasks assigned to resources. With the timeline view, project managers gain a visual representation of the work breakdown structure at varying timescales. The timeline view provides editing capabilities, allowing a project manager to define relationships between tasks, along with changing start dates and end dates of each task in the work breakdown structure. Once the work breakdown structure has been developed, users can leverage the resource assignment view to view and review the time phase estimations and confirm the contours meet expectations for each assignment. Once the resource estimates have been developed, project managers now have the ability to specify the expenses that are expected to be incurred to deliver the project, based upon organizational categories defined by each customer. Project managers can quantify each expense and associate them with categories or tasks. Once the time phase estimate has been deemed satisfactory, the project manager can engage the sales team to let them know the estimation has been completed, and the sales team can then update the quote with the accurate estimates based upon the project plan. At this point, the sales team does not need to rekey any estimate details, as the estimates from the project are natively integrated with the quote, along with the details. The sales team will have the flexibility to import the estimate with varying levels of detail based upon the work breakdown structure or categories defined on the project. With the quote submitted and the deal won, the project manager now has received the green light to staff the project. From the team member grid, the project manager has the ability to specify demand from a project-based team member based upon the role, the additional skills and proficiencies needed to fulfill the request. For organizations with central resource managers, the project manager submits this requirement to be fulfilled by a resource manager and subsequently reviews the proposal to close the requirement loop. Once the resource request has been submitted to the resource manager, they will review the inbound request and react either from a list of existing resource requests or from the schedule board, where multiple resource requirements can be triaged. The resource manager can leverage a schedule assistant to find a resource based upon the stated requirements related to effort, the role, and any other criteria in the resource requirement. Once the correct resource has been identified, the resource manager can submit the proposed resource back to the project manager for review. Once in their court, the project manager will review the proposed resource and have the ability to accept or reject the proposed resource. Once that resource has been accepted by the project manager, that resource will be added to the project team. They will replace the generic resource assigned to any tasks in the work breakdown structure, and the resource requirement can then be completed. During the life of the project, there may be realities that result in changes to the level of effort of a resource. With project operations, a project manager can quickly adjust the project plan to reflect what is needed to deliver the work, and from the resource reconciliation grid, the project manager will have the ability to extend the resources commitment to the project by extending their bookings. Once the project is in flight, project managers can leverage the tracking tab to get a view on the progress of the work. PMs can review the actuals approved at any level of the work breakdown structure, at the project level, the summary tasks, or leaf node tasks. PMs can adjust the remaining effort to accurately represent the estimate at completion, and for time and material projects, this also influences the associated revenue for each line item. Out of the box, project operations facilitates the reservation of a resource's capacity against a project. However, because project operations is integrated with URS, we also have the ability to define other entities as schedulable. In the example that we shared earlier, the project manager in our fictitious accounting firm staffed the project related to a specific customer engagement. Now we will take this one step further and illustrate how audits can be related to a project and be scheduled separately from a specific reservation of a resource on a project. We will review how we define an audit as a schedulable entity and share an example of how a customer would manage the requirements and bookings of the audit. We are very excited to share some new investments upcoming in the next wave. First off is schedule modes. In addition to the currently supported fixed duration scheduling mode, at the organizational level, customers will also have the ability to choose whether or not they want to schedule based upon fixed units or fixed work. The second investment related to task management is our ability to edit resource contours. Beyond defining scale of values for work, project operations will soon allow customers the ability to edit individual resource assignment contours. For the resource managers, we are introducing a new schedule board and schedule assistant experience. The new experience will provide a modern user interface with improved visual representations of bookings, along with more intuitive controls to manage the board. Lastly, for the developers, we are launching a new suite of APIs focused on the schedulable entities. These APIs will support create, update, and delete on tasks, resource assignments, task dependencies, and team members. Thank you for attending the session. If you're interested in learning more, we encourage you to connect with us on LinkedIn, Yammer, or our Dynamics communities. We also encourage you to visit our ideas portal. We hope you really enjoyed learning about project planning and resource management in project operations. Thank you.